Hey, Baron Davis, does this picture here take you back in the hallway before a playoff game, before the home crowd, and here
Absolutely.
You go?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, you can hear the crowd. Your adrenaline's going, your focus, everything is on the line. This is the most important game of your life.
I look at that lineup that's running out there, Ernie, and I see defenders. I see Amir Johnson, Avery Bradley, Rozier, Al Horford. I just look at guys who make Marcus Smart, guys who just make their living defending people. And that has been the difference between what Cleveland has not seen yet. That guys who can make things a little uncomfortable for them defensively. So we will see, I think, a different environment for the Cleveland Cavaliers for the first time in the playoffs.
The fact of the matter is, as we get to you, Shaq, the fact of the matter is the Boston Celtics are the number one seed, but they're the underdogs in this series. You don't often see a number one seed, an underdog, and a decided underdog against the Cleveland Cavaliers. How can Boston, as Avery Bradley says, look, this is our chance to show the world we're supposed to be here. How can they prove that they are equal to the Cleveland Cavaliers, if not better, in a series?
Round one versus the Bulls, that was study hall. Last series against the Wizards, that was a quiz. This is a test. It's a hard test. Coach Popovich said something very interesting yesterday about his team. He said, we didn't believe that we can beat. I know they're the number one seed, but my question to you guys is, do they really believe and think that they can beat the Kings?
This is how I know, B. Barrett, when you play with great defenders and you come to help and he goes, I don't need it, stay. If I see that language come around being in this arena a lot, then I know that they feel that they can beat them. Because I don't need help on LeBron. I don't need help on Kyrie. I don't need help all the time.
You don't need help on LeBron.
No,
are you kidding me?
No, I know what you're saying.
Are you kidding me?
The greatest defenders
can't guard
might
LeBron
need
James.
It. No,
you're not guarding
need
LeBron
it,
one-on-one.
But they might not believe they want it.
No, for
There's
sure.
a difference. Wanting it and believing that you need it. There's a big difference.
And playing a Cleveland team here, Baron, playing its best basketball of the season. Their longest winning streak in the regular season was 6. They are now the first team to ever go 8-0 to start consecutive postseasons, just running past Indiana and Toronto. So what's the biggest challenge that Boston presents to Cleveland?
I think the biggest challenge that Boston may present to Cleveland is really Cleveland, you know, and their complacency or them settling for, you know, having mental lapses and turning the ball over. I don't really think that I like Boston. I think they're competitive. They'll be scrappy. But I think Cleveland can be their own worst enemy at times with turning the ball over and being complacent. And so if they do that, then, you know, this team is on a mission. They're a buzzsaw. They're ready to rock.
Can I say that in a different way?
Sure.
Cleveland Cavaliers sometimes become front runners. They get happy. When they're winning games, you see guys grabbing beers. You see guys high-fiving, doing bottle flips.
Let them be grabbing beers.
No question. But when they're losing or when they get tested, at times we don't see that same jovial atmosphere. So we call that front running. So they lost 31 games this year. There's a reason they lost 31 as well, because they can get complacent. They can get happy, and they can think that it's too easy at times. We'll see if that happens here.
I kind of agree with that, but, you know, you played on teams where you were so good that you just wanted to get through the regular season.
That's true.
And, you know, they made it known many times that, listen, we don't care where we're placed. Boston, if you want the number one seed, you go and take it. Everybody talking about a switch. They have that switch that they can turn on.
They do have a switch.
Yeah, they do have a switch they can turn, and I think they know what's at stake.
He has a switch there, that guy.
Yes, and
he
you
has
know
a
what?
Switch too.
And you know what? The monkey was taken off LeBron's back last year when they won, but guess what? They got an opportunity to get back-to-back championships.
Cleveland shooting 49% in this postseason, 43% from distance, and they are 8-0 through the first two rounds.